Greetings, everyone. I'm sitting here with Dr. Chonti Rott. Some of you will know her, some of you will not. Hopefully a lot of you will get to know her. She's a pretty awesome doctor. So we haven't been around for a while because we've moved, so we had to get things organized, but we're in this great new space here, feeling good. And we decided to get back onto the YouTube bandwagon. So today we're going to talk a little bit about stem cells. So we're doing a lot of stem cells right now. A little bit of confusion about what stem cells are, how to go about doing them, who should use them. So we're going to try and address at least some of your questions today. So, but before I start, I want to explain a little bit how to purchase stem cells. Doesn't have to be here, but please think about the following that I'm going to tell you. So with stem cells, quality is paramount. Very, very important. So a lot of newbies who haven't done any research, you guys will say my budget is X thousand dollars, and you will Google and say, right, this place offers us, I don't know, 50 million, 100 million, 200 million stem cells. The one that gives us the most, that's the best one. Do not do that. Why? Most likely, the place that has a high amount of stem cells will use cryo-frozen stem cells. They're not bad stem cells, don't get me wrong, but they are not the best type of stem cells. So when you freeze something, as everyone knows, you get cell death. It's unavoidable. Take a piece of meat, nice prime Angus steak, stick it in the freezer, take it out, it'll taste okay. When you defrost it, you'll get water. It just won't be great, right? But you put that same piece of steak on your grill, it's going to be an awesome piece of meat. Same thing with stem cells. Quality is paramount. If you have very good cells, you don't need huge amounts of cells because they are fresh. So here at Revival Clinic, we use fresh cells. They arrive from the lab maximum 30 minutes before the patient arrives. We have a time-stamped folder with all the tests, analysis. It says how many cells there are. It says the viability of the cells, how old they are, best before, within a couple of hours. Our cells have never, ever been frozen. Very important. Not a lot of places do that because the answer is simple. It's just pure economics. Not bad mouthing anyone, but just be aware of that, because the more cells you get, the more trouble you can possibly get into. So if you have large amounts of cells, you can, in the worst case, I'm not saying this happens all the time, but in the worst case, if you have an issue with your lungs, you could actually drown because there's so many cells going to your lungs. So just please look for quality rather than quantity. We have small quantities because they're very, very potent, our cells. They work very quickly. If you have our cells in huge numbers, again, probably too much of a good thing. But anyway, I just wanted to start with that because it's very important. So go with a good place that has very good cells, that has experience in this as well. So I think the rest of this, I'm going to need the help of the good doctor here. She's the professional, not me. I'm just a good talker. So I want to address a few of the questions that we get on a daily basis.
Mm-mm.
So firstly, just in short, what are stem cells?
Stem cell is a special type of cell that can divide itself indefinitely. And not only divide itself, it can differentiate into variety kind of cell. For example, if you have any injury in your body, the job of stem cell is to divide itself and differentiate into that type of cell to go to repair.
Okay, so stem cells can become a lot of different types of cells?
Yes, can be like heart cell, blood cell, skin cell, brain cell, liver cell, kidney cell,
yeah, so
pancreas cell.
It's pretty, so like They don't call the stem cells a miracle cell for nothing. So, okay. Another thing that people ask us about, especially coming from overseas, they ask if we use bone marrow cells.
Mm.
We don't. We use umbilical cord tissue, sometimes called Wharton's jelly. Why do we use this versus other types of cells?
The short, simply reason is because it's more effective. If you follow the Poseidon trial, this is already proof that the allogenic, it means that stem cell from somebody else, healthy, is more effective than stem cell from yourself, which can be aging and got effect from your chronic disease too. So we're looking for the most effective stem cell. If we can reach the source of cell that more effective, why not?
So younger cells better?
The younger, the better.
And also when you use bone marrow cells, they're always the age of the donor. So a 30-year-old, a 50-year-old, a 70-year-old, stem cells, but old stem cells. Umbilical cord stem cells, zero age stem cells. Mm. What's next? A lot of people ask about safety. Are stem cells safe? What are the reactions that you can expect? In terms of safety, allergic reactions, these kind of things.
If you choose stem cell from the good lab, select the kit at the right place, right time, right indication, I'm gonna say in my hand, it's zero risk. I never seen any side effect from using stem cell. But in my practical, like if I remember a long time ago, when I working with medicine in hospital, from medicine, I saw many kind of side effects from medicine, but I never seen in my hand from stem cell.
Okay. I was talking in the beginning about the quality of stem cells, which is super important. What happens if you get a bad lab? We use a very good lab. I would say we use best lab. But what if you use a bad lab? What can happen?
Bad cell, it means bad result. There's one incident in US that multiple care that gets stem cell and have and send them to ICU. That's because the lab not approved, like not don't have standard, and it get like contamination. That's one case. From my experience, one time I met a guy who gets stem cell from somewhere else, and that treatment also sent him to ICU. So imagine if you get millions of good cell in your body, this small cell will go and repair. But imagine if you get bad cell instead, it can be the workload for your body to remove or cause the negative result.
Yeah, so again, it's counterproductive. So if you're using loads of cells, which usually people do, they use loads of cells because you have lesser quality cells, so they try to make up for the dead cells that have been frozen. They enter your body and immediately they start battling to get rid of the bad cells. So it really is counterproductive. Go with really good quality cells. So another question, we're using umbilical cord stem cells. The mother is sick. Now, just before the doctor explains this, all donors are severely, severely screened. I mean, before they even can donate their umbilical cords. But let's say the mother has an issue. Will I get her? Let's say she has AIDS or she has, I don't know, something horrible. What are the risks that I will get it through the stem cells that are taken from her umbilical cord?
We are lucky that we in the time that we have all kinds of technology to prevent this. Imagine if you got a car accident and you need blood transfusion. We're gonna screen all kinds of infectious disease too. Mm. But what we do more for the stem cell, we even screen to the family history to make sure that we get the good source. We screen the age of the donor to make sure that like it's not from elderly pregnancy. So we do all kinds of stuff to make sure that this will give only the positive effect.
Okay. Mm-hmm. So I want to discuss a little bit what we're seeing in real life cases. Reading about stuff in research is fine. There's conflicting things, there's positive, there's negatives. What I like to do is see real life cases, and we have enough real life cases. We've been doing this for years and years and years, so we have real life cases. Now, one thing that everyone, I'll say 99% of people, they sleep better. A lot of people who have issues with like back pain, any kind of inflammation, everyone has said within a day or two they feel better, have less pain. And this is because stem cells, number one, they home. Number two, they deal with inflammation. These are the things that they do really quickly, right?
And also immune modulation.
Correct. So they just feel generally better. Another thing for you gentlemen there, every single person says that they have much improvement in their wiggly bits. Good thing. Not everyone has a problem with that, but even people who have a lot of stamina, shall we say, are sort of seeing peak performance there. So that's a really good thing with the stem cells. If you need it or not, call it a bonus. Otherwise, we have things like fast recovery in gyms. We see that people lift more weights. They get tired less often. These are the things that you see immediately. 1, 2, 3 days like that. Every single person. Our cells show results very, very quickly. What can a person expect in month 3 to 6, for example?
I will say the overall well-being. That's all we need for help. You want to not to be sick and ill, able to sleep, being happy, enjoy your daily life with family. If I want to stress it, for example, if you have underlying problem that you can see the change, it's like if you have lung problem from chronic smoking, many people feedback that this is the first time that they can breathe freely, deeply, like they never experienced before. What they said is like they feel that their lung turned back to be before it got damaged from the smoke.
Yeah, that happened to me. I did stem cells 3 years ago. Smoker. Had a black dot on my on my yearly x-ray. Did stem cells. Went back, doctor asked what had I done. I said stem cells, and he went, ah. But the amazing thing was my sense of smell. I thought I could smell pretty well. But after the stem cells, in a few days, I could smell a cat down the street with flatulence. I'm not kidding. I mean, my nose was, I was like a bloodhound. It was amazing. So that I can attest to myself. I also had high blood pressure, like 147 to 150-ish. That was constant. Tried medicines. They worked. Not good to do it, so I stopped. Tried exercising. It did go down a little bit, but it was never really good. Now, stem cells or not, I can't prove it. But now, I mean, 118, 120, 123, like, that's the norm. I'm 53 years young. I don't have any medical issues at all, no medication, nothing. I haven't been sick since I did the stem cells like 3 years ago. I cannot get COVID. I've tried. I wanted to get it over and done with. My family got COVID. I have a young son. I tried everything to get the COVID, just can't, I can't do it. Does stem cell stop COVID? No. Did stem cells make my immune system stronger? I think definitely, because I haven't been sick in 3 years. Things like that. These are the kind of things you expect to see from stem cell therapy. So who should do stem cells, and how old should they be roughly?
Nobody want to aging and sick, right? So I think if you can afford it, stem cell is good treatment that's safe for you. How old should you start? I think roughly it's about 35 to 40 something, depends on your underlying disease. If you have early onset of age relays disease, maybe you start earlier.
And typically, you know, is this, how often would you have to do it? Is it just you have to do it every year? Do you do it, I don't know. But
that depends on your economy
again
and lifestyle.
So in a perfect world, how often would you do a stem cell treatment? I guess it depends how many stem cells you do too, is that correct?
Yes.
Okay. So let's say you did I don't know, on the upper end of our stem cell treatments, how often would you recommend to do it in a perfect world?
Once a year, once every 3 years.
So it's hard to say, right? So basically what we've basically told people is, you know, don't just listen to your body, and your body will tell you that, because it's quite difficult to say, you know, everybody should do stem cells every year, every 2 years, but basically listen to your body and your body's never wrong. I think we've pretty much covered what most people have asked us. If you have any more questions or wonder anything about stem cells, all the channels that you can reach us on are on our webpage, revivalclinicbangkok.com, and we welcome any sort of inquiries or questions you may have. And that's it for this time. Thank you.
Thank you.